Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. Chery Automobile is a Chinese automaker, and it is the fifth-largest automobile manufacturer in the country. The system they developed for plug-in hybrid vehicles is highly complex, featuring two motor generators, three clutches, and a three-speed transmission. This system is called 3DHT and is used in the large SUV, the Tiggo 9. Compared to Toyota's system, which has only two motor generators and a planetary gear set, it's like comparing Japanese cuisine to Chinese cuisine. In this video, we will explore Chery Automobile's hybrid system. At the end, we will compare it with Toyota's system. Let's first take a look at the structure. Clutch 1 is positioned between the gasoline engine and MG1. MG stands for motor generator. The output from MG1 is transmitted to clutch 2 and clutch 3. Gear 2 is connected to clutch 3. Gear 1 and gear 3 are connected to clutch 2. MG2 is connected to gear 3 through a reduction gear. The gears on the output shaft mesh respectively with gear 1, gear 2, gear 3, and the differential's ring gear. A shifting mechanism is positioned between gear 1 and gear 3 on the output shaft. In EV mode first gear, where the vehicle runs solely on electricity stored in the battery, clutches 1, 2, and 3 are disengaged. The shifting mechanism on the output shaft engages gear 1 with the output shaft. As a result, the output from MG2 is transmitted in the order of the reduction gear, gear 3, gear 1, and the output shaft. In EV mode second gear, MG1 also operates as a traction motor, and its output is combined with the output of MG2. By engaging clutches 2 and 3, the outputs of MG1 and MG2 are combined through these clutches and transmitted to the output shaft via gear 2. The shifting mechanism on the output shaft is in the neutral position, and gears 1 and 3 are idling. When the battery level drops below a certain level, the system operates as a series hybrid. It engages clutch 1 to operate MG1 as a generator, and MG2 runs on the electricity generated by MG1. Since clutches 2 and 3 are disengaged, the engine is not involved in driving the vehicle. The shifting mechanism on the output shaft engages the output shaft with gear 3. The output from MG2 is transmitted to the output shaft through gear 3. In single motor regenerative braking, all clutches are disengaged, and the shifting mechanism on the output shaft engages the output shaft with gear 3. The rotation of the wheels is transmitted in sequence through the output shaft, gear 3, and MG2, operating MG2 as a generator to charge the battery. In dual motor regenerative braking, clutches 2 and 3 are engaged, and the shifting mechanism on the output shaft is in the neutral position. The rotation of the wheels is distributed through clutches 2 and 3, operating both MG1 and MG2 as generators to charge the battery. In engine mode first gear, clutches 1 and 2 are engaged. The shifting mechanism on the output shaft engages gear 1 with the output shaft. The engine output is transmitted to the output shaft via clutch 1, clutch 2, and gear 1. In engine mode second gear, clutches 1 and 3 are engaged. The shifting mechanism on the output shaft is in the neutral position. The engine output is transmitted to the output shaft via clutch 1, clutch 3, and gear 2. In engine mode third gear, clutches 1 and 2 are engaged. The shifting mechanism on the output shaft engages gear 3 with the output shaft. The engine output is transmitted to the output shaft via clutch 1, clutch 2, and gear 3. Parallel hybrid mode combines the outputs of the drive motor and the engine. Clutches 1 and 2 are engaged, and the shifting mechanism engages gear 1 with the output shaft. In parallel mode 1, The engine output and MG2 output are combined. In parallel mode 2, the MG1 output is added to the engine output shaft. In parallel mode 3, the engine output is combined with the outputs of MG1 and MG2. In this mode as well, similar to the engine mode, the system can shift from first to third gear by switching the clutches and the shifting mechanism. From the operations described above, we can see that the Chery 3DHT system is fundamentally a series hybrid, while the use of three clutches and a three-speed transmission also allows it to operate as a parallel hybrid, making it a series parallel hybrid system. Because it has three gear ratios, it allows both the engine and the electric motor to operate within their high-efficiency speed ranges, improving fuel economy as well as electrical energy efficiency. Generally, in two-motor hybrid systems, each motor serves a different role. For example, MG1 functions as a generator while MG2 acts as a traction motor, and they do not perform the same function at the same time. However, in the 3DHT system, both electric motors can operate simultaneously either as drive motors or as generators. If both electric motors can be used at the same time for the same function, each motor only needs to supply half the power, which is a very rational and efficient approach. In summary, the Chery 3DHT system allows the engine and electric motors to operate mostly within their high-efficiency ranges, while using two small, low-power motors to deliver adequate overall power. However, designing and calibrating this complex combination to operate smoothly was probably not an easy task. Until now, series hybrids have lagged behind Toyota's hybrid systems. This graph illustrates one example, comparing the fuel economy of compact cars from Nissan and Honda equipped with series hybrids to that of Toyota's compact cars. For more details on this graph, check out this video. The link is in the description. Has the Chery hybrid that is based on a series hybrid been able to catch up with Toyota's hybrid? We will clarify its performance by comparing it with the Chery Tiggo 9 and the Lexus RX 450h+. The Chery is front-wheel drive, while the Lexus is all-wheel drive, and the data is primarily for the South African specification. The Chery weighs 2,220 kg, while the Lexus is 2,105 to 2,200 kg. The weight for the Chery is based on the Australian AWD specification. The FWD model may be slightly lighter, but the difference is small enough that it won't affect the fuel economy comparison. The Chery is equipped with a 1.5-liter turbocharged engine with a maximum output of 115 kilowatts, while the Lexus uses a 2.5-liter naturally aspirated engine with a maximum output of 136 kilowatts. The maximum output of the front motor is 165 kilowatts for the Chery and 134 kilowatts for the Lexus. The datasheet for the Chery Australia includes entries for front 1 and front 2. From this, we can confirm that the system combines two relatively low-output electric motors. Although the Lexus is AWD and therefore equipped with a rear motor, it is assumed to have almost no effect on fuel efficiency. So we will disregard it here. The Chery has a system total output of 280 kilowatts, while the Lexus has 227 kilowatts. The battery capacity and electric driving range are nearly the same for both the Chery and the Lexus. Finally, fuel economy. The Chery consumes 1.5 liters per 100 kilometers, while the Lexus consumes 1.3 liters per 100 kilometers, making the Lexus about 15% more efficient. However, these figures are based on the PHEV fuel economy standard, which takes into account both the electric driving range and motor efficiency. Is there no figure we can use to judge the performance of the hybrid system? The Chery South Africa datasheet lists the fuel economy when the battery capacity is below 30%. It can be assumed that this represents the fuel economy in hybrid mode. On the other hand, the Japanese spec datasheet for the Lexus lists the fuel economy in hybrid mode. Let's try comparing these two values. the Chery is catching up to the Lexus quite closely. However, this comparison is also not completely fair. The Lexus figures are measured under Japan's WLTC standard, while the Chery figures are based on Europe's older NEDC standard. WLTC involves more demanding driving conditions, but it is measured only up to 100 km per hour, whereas NEDC goes up to 120 km per hour. So it's not clear which test is more favorable in terms of fuel economy. In any case, it is fair to say that Chery Series Hybrid System, which features three clutches and a three-speed transmission, has come closer to Toyota's hybrid system. A note of caution. Never forget that this video focuses solely on the fuel efficiency of the hybrid systems. It does not address drivability, noise, vibration, or reliability at all, so please keep that in mind. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.